What do you use to take your screenshots? I would guess to say most of you desktop Linux users use a graphical application to take your screenshots with, but today I want to show you a really cool command line utility called Scrot. It is a command line screenshot utility, and why would you use a command line interface program over a graphical program to take screenshots with? Well, command line interface programs allow you to incorporate those programs in shell scripting, for example. For example, maybe you want to include a screenshot function in a dmenu script or a Rofi script, those of you that use those command launchers. Command line utilities allow you to do that where graphical applications really don't lend themselves to such a thing. So let me pull up a web browser and we'll read a little bit about Scrot. Now I'm going to pull up the Wikipedia page on Scrot rather than like a GitHub or a GitLab page or some official website. And the reason I'm going to do that is because Scrot really doesn't have a website anywhere. It actually has not seen a major release in almost two decades. The last release of Scrot was way back in June of 2003. That's, you know, nearly 17 years ago. Don't let that scare you. I know in the past when I've shown you guys programs or applications that haven't been updated in many, many years, some of you guys fear those applications. You think, you know, it's not under development. Is it even safe to run on my system? It's fine, guys. It's just a screenshot utility anyway. It's pretty much feature complete, and even if it had a maintainer still actively maintaining it, there really isn't anything else that needs to be done with Scrot. It's a very simple application. It does one thing, and it really does one thing well. Features of Scrot include the ability to limit the scope of capturing to a specific screen area. So when we invoke Scrot at the command line, we can tell Scrot to take a full screen screenshot, or we can tell it, hey, take a screenshot of just the application with focus. Can give it a specific area of the screen called a section of the screen that it takes a screenshot of. For example, I have a 3-monitor system, and sometimes if I take a screenshot, I don't want to take a screenshot of all 3 screens. Maybe I just want 1 monitor in the screenshot, or maybe I just want 1 program on 1 monitor in the screenshot. Scrot gives you that flexibility. Other things you can do with Scrot is you can delay the time of the screenshot so the screenshot doesn't get taken immediately. You know, you can delay it 5 seconds, 10 seconds, whatever you want. So let's take a look at Scrot in action. So let me pull up my desktop here and let me go ahead and launch a terminal. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you guys can see. So I've already got Scrot installed, but if I didn't, on Arch, you would sudo pacman-S Scrot. On Debian or Ubuntu, sudo apt install Scrot. We take a look at the Scrot man page. I could man Scrot, and it gives us some of the flags for Scrot, which are -h for help to get more information, -v to just check the version of Scrot, -a for auto select, -b for border, etc. Some of the most common flags you will use will be -u, which takes a screenshot of the area of focus, and -s, which is select. It lets you interactively select the area of the screen, the window on the screen that you want to take the screenshot of. It allows you to actually click on it with the mouse. And when you click on it with the mouse, you know, Scrot will take the screenshot of that window. I'm going to scroll back up in the man page here, and you see to invoke Scrot, you need to do Scrot, and then the options, the flags, and then the name of the file. You need to specify a file name. Let's quit out of the man page. So the most basic way to run Scrot is to run Scrot and then the name of the image. So we're about to take a screenshot and we're going to name this one. I'll call it image new, and we'll save it as a ping, image-new.ping. And we just took a screenshot of my desktop and it saved it as image-new.ping. Where did it store image-new.ping? Well, of course, it stored it in the directory we're currently in, which happens to be my home directory. If I do an ls somewhere in here, you should see image-new.ping. Now, let me clear the screen. Some of the other flags we talked about, of course, were Scrot space -v, which gives us the version. Again, it hasn't seen an update in nearly 20 years, so it's not like you're going to need to check the version of Scrot very often. Now let me show you one of the more interesting flags with Scrot, the U flag. So Scrot -u, this just takes a screenshot of the window with focus. The window with focus right now is just my terminal. I take that screenshot. I didn't specify a name, so by default, if you don't specify a name, it's going to name it with a timestamp .jpg, I believe. So if I do an ls, and somewhere in here I will find, actually it saved it as a ping. It saved it right here, and it gave us timestamp. Let's go ahead and open this. I'm going to open it in my file viewer SXIV. And you see the screenshot should be a very wide screenshot if it's a full screen screenshot, because I have three monitors. But because I used the U flag, it only took a screenshot of the area with focus, which was just the terminal window. Now let me open up another terminal window just to have a second window on the screen, and let me show you scrot space dash s. This is the interactive way to select the area of the screen that you want to take a screenshot. You see my cursor has turned into an X. Whatever window I click on, it will take a screenshot of. Maybe I want to take a screenshot of the window back here. I just click on it, boom. Scrot just took a screenshot of just this back window, not the one right here in front. Of course, you can combine flags. Maybe I want to scrot dash S, which is the interactive command for me to select a window, and I could also give it the B flag, meaning take a screenshot of that window, but do not include the border of the window. I could run that and then, you know, select a window and it will take the screenshot. Again, all of these are being put in my home directory right now. These three right here are those last three that I ran. To delay your screenshots, what you would do, you would run scrot space dash D for delay, and then the number of seconds you wish to delay, for example, 5 seconds, and it will wait 5 seconds, and then it takes the screenshot. Now let me CD into one of my directories here that I've got some dmenu scripts. If I do an ls, I have a script in here called dmenu dash scrot. Let's go ahead and open that. I'll open it up in Vim. So, and this is basically just a bash script. And what it does is when I execute this command, I have a key binding that executes this dmenu script. You see, it's going to create a dmenu that has these options. Take a scrot as quick full screen, delayed full screen, just take a screenshot of the section. You know, it allows you that interactive selection with the mouse. But let's see this in action. If I hit my key binding to launch that menu, you see I have a dmenu here. And it says local screenshots are saved at image path. And I created a folder called scrot in my home directory. And that's where all my scrot screenshots are going to be saved that are run through this dmenu script. So if I do a quick full screen right now and just hit enter, it just took a full screen. And you see, I even got a notification. It just took a full screen screenshot. And that screenshot will be in my home directory slash scrot. You can see image path equals home slash dt slash scrot. And this is really the power of having a command line interface tool rather than a graphical tool, is you get this kind of flexibility with scripting and playing with things like dmenu. By the way, that quick full screen command that I executed, you can see in the bash script, it executes scrot dash d for delay. Delay it 1 second. You know, you never want to do just an instant screenshot, because they're, you know, you always want to delay it at least half a second, even if you want it instant. So you delay it 1 second, then name it as this time and date format dash scrot dot ping and notify send. Now this gives us a notification. You saw the notification window that said, hey, you just took a screenshot. That was run with this part of the command, the notify send command, and basically tells us scrot, and then full screen taken and saved. So let me get out of Vim and get into my scrot directory and CD into that, and then do a ls, and you will see some of the screenshots I have taken using that dmenu scrot script, including the very last one. So if I wanted to check it out and just to make sure that screenshot worked, well, let's go ahead and use some tab complete here. And that was the screenshot I just took. You can see I was in Vim. I'm recording this video in OBS. So that screenshot worked just fine. So the dmenu script is running just fine. And of course, you could edit a script like that to do whatever it is you need your screenshot utility to do. If you take screenshots all the time in a variety of different ways, in a variety of different formats, The power of a simple command line utility like Scrype is really what you want to use. You combine it with a run launcher like Dmenu or Rofi, it really is unbeatable. Now, before I go, I do want to thank a few special people. This show was made possible by Ansem, Chris, Daniel, David, DJ, Stallman, Donnie, Dylan, George, Haplo, Nate, Corbinian, Lambda, Liam, Mitchell, Natech, Rob, Robert, Sean, and Willie. They are the producers of the show. These guys are my highest-tiered patrons over on Patreon. Without these guys, this episode about this awesome command line screenshot utility called Scrype, it wouldn't have been possible. Also want to thank all those other names you see on the screen, all those fine ladies and gentlemen that help support my work over on Patreon. If you'd like to support the channel, please consider doing so. You'll find me at DistroTube over on Patreon. All right, guys. Peace.